Good morning dear students, now we see standard 6 science unit 2 water. Water is one of the basic substances present in the earth. It plays a vital role in the evolution and the survival of life. It is impossible to imagine life on the earth without water. Water helps to regulate the temperature of our planet. It also helps to maintain the temperature in organisms. Now we will see where do we get water from. Water is available in nature in three forms, that is solid, liquid and vapor. Solid form of water. It is present in icebergs and ice caps on top of tall mountains, glaciers and polar regions. Next one is liquid form of water. Water. It is present in oceans, seas, lakes, rivers and even underground. Next one is gaseous form of water. Vapor. It is present in air around us. Now we see about the availability of water. We know that nearly 3/4 of the surface of earth is covered with water. Most of the water, that is 97% of total amount of water that exists on earth, that is found in seas and oceans. Look at the pie chart. Can we drink the water available in sea? No. Because sea water is salty, but water used for our daily purposes is not salty. It is known as fresh water. Water obtained from ponds, puddles, river, tube wells and taps at home is usually fresh water. If the total water on earth be 100%, let's see what percent would be the availability of fresh water. Now we see about the components of water. Water is a transparent, tasteless, odorless and nearly colorless chemical substance. It is composed of two atoms of hydrogen combined with one atom of oxygen. So the molecular formula of water is H2O. However, the physical composition of water changes from place to place. It can be clear or cloudy, oxygenated or not very oxygenated, and it can be fresh or salty. Now we'll see about the water cycle. Water cycle is a continuous process. It involves three stages, that are evaporation, condensation and precipitation. It is also called hydrological cycle. Now we will see the first one, evaporation. Water from oceans, lakes, ponds and rivers evaporates due to the heat of the sun. Next one is the condensation. Water vapor which enters into the atmosphere by evaporation, it moves upward with air, gets cool and changes into tiny water droplets that form clouds in the sky. And the last one is the precipitation. The millions of tiny droplets collide with one another to form large droplets. When the air around the cloud is cool, these drops of water fall on the form of snow or rain. Now we'll see the next topic, natural sources of fresh water. There are three type of natural sources fresh water are available on the earth, that are surface water, frozen water and ground water. Now we will see the first one, surface water. Water present on surface of the earth such as river, lake, ponds, streams or fresh water with hand is called surface water. Next one is frozen water. Water that is present in the frozen form as polar ice caps and glaciers are called frozen water. A large portion of water is 68.7% of the total available fresh water is in frozen state, and the last type is groundwater. Groundwater is the water present beneath the earth's surface in soil. This water is obtained through springs, open wells, tube wells, or hand pumps. Now we'll see about the condensation of water. There is no change in the total quantity of water available on earth. It remains the same, but the water useful for plants, animals, and man is decreasing day by day. It is called scarcity of water. What are the reasons for scarcity of water? That are population explosion, decline distribution of rainfall, decline of ground water table, pollution of water, careless use of water. Now we'll see how are the methods used for water conservation. Mainly two methods can be used for the conservation of water. One is water management and another one is rainwater harvesting. We will see the water management. Water management consists of some factors that are bringing awareness about the bad effects of throwing waste into the water bodies, recycling of water by separating pollutants, minimizing the use of chemical fertilizers in agriculture. It reduces the pollution of underground water, controlling the deforestation, adopting drip irrigation and sprinkler irrigation in agriculture. By this way, lesser amount of water can be used for irrigation. And the next type is rainwater harvesting. Direct collection and use of rainwater is called rainwater harvesting. There are two types of rainwater harvesting. One is collecting water from where it falls, and another one is collecting flowing rainwater. The first one, collecting water from where it falls. Collecting water from the rooftops of the houses or buildings. The next one is collecting flowing rainwater. Collecting rainwater by constructing ponds with a bund. Now we see the importance of water. Our body uses water in all its cells, organs and tissues to help regulate its temperature and maintain other bodily functions. On an average, the human body requires 2 to 3 liters of water per day for proper functioning. Water helps in digestion of food and removal of toxins from the body. Importance of water in domestic purposes. Apart from drinking, people use water for many other purposes. These include cooking, bathing, washing clothes, washing utensils, keeping houses and common places clean, watering plants, etc. In agriculture, water is also essential for the healthy growth of farm crops and farm stock, and is used in the manufacture of many products. Last one is in industry. Industry depends on water at all levels of production. It is used as a material, a solvent, and for generating electricity. Thank you, students.